Cinema is considered to serve as a powerful art form that transcends all boundaries of human emotion. Filmmakers across the globe have utilized this as a fundamental dimension of visual storytelling to convey their perspectives. It is because of their exemplary efforts and never-ending enthusiasm to create something extraordinary that has resulted in a remarkable evolution of the world of cinema. One such director, who has gained the cult status of being a visionary and a provocateur, who has become one of the many faces of world cinema when it comes to following a distinctive art form and possessing unthinkably vivid imagination, is none other than Lars von Trier. What comes in your mind when you hear his name? Controversial perspectives, pornographic portrayal, or emotional devastation? Von Trier is one of the most controversial directors who is known for his abstract expressionism and fearless decisions in terms of storytelling. His movies reflect a different form of cinema that surely makes the audience uncomfortable, but at the same time compels them to take a deep dive and understand the true meaning of what the visuals are trying to convey. His language and understanding of cinema has divided his audience into two categories: those who widely appreciate his efforts and the rest who deeply criticize his ideas and execution. Von Trier has introduced us to characters like Bess from Breaking the Waves, Selma from Dancer in the Dark, Grace from Dogville, She from Antichrist, Justine of Melancholia, and Joe in Nymphomaniac. Each and every character is a culmination of multi-layered emotional depth and represents varied personalities dealing with issues that only they can understand. Their grief is associated with resolving inner conflicts, and they wish to defeat and free themselves from the handcuffs of preconceived notions, judgmental behavior, and of course, the highest forms of patriarchy. Every character stands on the zenith of a damaged psychological state, a state where the world feels like a place full of malice and hatred, which is a consequence of how their actions and thoughts have been condemned by the society, which in turn leads to self-doubt and degradation. Von Trier is a pure genius when it comes to utilizing the power of visuals. He masterfully intrigues and makes the viewer sit on the front seat during the emotional expedition so that we don't just recognize but also realize and feel the emotional trauma experienced by the protagonist. That's when we do become distressed after the revelation of their bitter reality. But every character ends up creating a special spot in our heart. Now, sometimes we might call these characters problematic personalities, but then Von Trier pivots our attention towards the ultimate reality that these people are humans and their story deserves to be heard in the loudest voice. It won't be wrong to say that Von Trier is someone who firmly believes in telling the untold stories. Stories that are genuinely about life and the difficulties of existing as humans. Stories that are focused on exploring the uncharted boundaries of human sentiments. But they tend to get unnoticed and are sometimes banished by the power of ignorance, fueled by the illusion of life being a cakewalk, which is definitely not true. At least for Von Trier himself. When it comes to the utilization of filmmaking as an art form, every director wishes to share his or her own perspective and bring something different to the table. In a lot of interviews, Von Trier has compared himself with a chef who would work on a potato or a piece of meat, and his choice of ingredients over a period of time has indeed left everyone in a state of shock. He is an innovative auteur in the world of cinema who has established himself as a refined, independent filmmaker. He has given birth to a popular and notorious segregation of his ideas with his artistic decisions. Just like the other members of the film fraternity, Von Trier has also taken charge of depicting his own observations and viewpoint of the world through his eyes. Some of his critics who use words like vomitive, pathetic, and unbearable might never transform to becoming his admirers, but then it seems that Von Trier doesn't wish for that either. After a monumental career spanning across 4 decades, Von Trier has made over 11 films that are regarded as highly ambitious and remarkable pieces of art. Each film stands as a case study based on a particular subject matter. But more than that, each film represents his thought process and a phase of Von Trier's life. The character arcs include a brilliant incorporation of his own emotions. A movie can act as a medium to communicate a certain idea or interpretation of something that exists universally. And Von Trier has this phenomenal ability to indirectly disclose his own understanding about something that would mostly stay behind the curtains. His filmography can be described as his own memoir in parts. But this doesn't mean that the nature of his films is entirely autobiographical. His meticulous research and planning to give birth to a character shines bright in every frame and justifies his usage of allegory and symbolism. In an interview with creativescreenwriting.com, he expressed how highly he regards and follows the legendary director Carl Theodor Dreyer, who would spend many years on a single script. Von Trier follows a similar approach by conducting in-depth research and spending copious amounts of time in perfecting his scripts. And not just that, the visuals of his films are as captivating as the storyline. His dedicated approach, resulting in a superior finesse, can be credited to his decision to declare the Dogma 95 movement in collaboration with fellow Danish filmmaker Thomas Vinterberg. With this movement, the director duo introduced the world to the vows of chastity, a set of rules that would define how a film will be presented in its purest form without the inclusion of any special effects and focusing heavily on the actors' performances. Except for The Idiots, Von Trier has been experimenting with the principal photography and post-production for his films. He applies a mix of both realism and expressionism when it comes to the treatment of his scripts. And that has definitely resulted in mind-boggling imagery that speaks volumes about not just what's happening in the film, but also what's happening in the world in general. This approach to condense numerous ideas into a single sequence is what makes us uncomfortable, but at the same time leaves us engrossed and awestruck. But there are still a few methods mentioned in the Dogma 95 manifesto that still remain intact. The best example being the handheld camera, which still remains his weapon of choice in order to keep the realism alive in his films. It goes without saying that Von Trier's films talk a lot about subjects like mental health, sexual awakening, patriarchy, and the unapologetic mindset of the society. Basically, everything that nobody gives attention turns out to be his primary subject matter. His filmography includes 3 different set of trilogies. Now, amongst these three, the Depression trilogy has awarded Von Trier with a well-deserving appreciation. But these films have also casted a shadow of doubt in the minds of many moviegoers who have condemned him for how he treats and delivers his ideas. These 3 films, Antichrist, Melancholia, and The Nymphomaniac, deal with female characters who are suffering from depression and grief in many different ways. Now, these films offer everything like magnificent visuals, breathtaking performances, and thought-provoking multi-layered storylines. These films are definitely one of the most memorable pieces of cinema. What they don't offer is a happy ending. But still, Von Trier likes to call Melancholia the happiest ending he has ever made. Melancholia is the story of Justine, played by Kirsten Dunst, for whom the entire world around her is falling apart as she starts experiencing deepest levels of sadness and, well, melancholy. The movie is divided into 2 chapters with an operatic prologue that shows how planet Earth is inching towards total annihilation, since it is going to collide with another planet. Now, this is exactly what's happening with Justine as well. She is unfortunately progressing towards an emotional annihilation, which gets heightened to the stage of depression in the 2nd chapter of the film. Right from the beginning of chapter 1, the audience is made to realize that everything is literally going haywire for Justine. Her marriage becomes a nightmare. She is mistreated by her boss, which seems nothing new, and her state of mind gets paralyzed to the highest degree. Justine's sister Claire and her nephew Leo represent two different stages of mind. On one hand, where Justine has become one with grief and doesn't want to escape from her death, Claire tries her best to escape from this event. Since the mindset of a child remains occupied in a different dimension, Leo doesn't seem to get bothered a lot with the occurrence of this event. His age makes him less vulnerable to develop an understanding of the complexity of death. Now, the part where this movie feels like giving a sense of hope amidst the unstoppable face of destruction is where Justine says that there is indeed a place where they can hide. She then takes Leo to gather some sticks so that they can make their magic cave. Now, if we look carefully, these visuals are somehow hinting towards the Genesis. Millions of years ago, when the world was formed with the birth of microorganisms, these scenes take us back in the time where Homo sapiens were learning about various survival techniques that eventually led to the evolution of the entire human race. Now, this means that just like how the nature and the power of creation is ready to give you another chance to begin again, there is always the hope to start a new life. No matter how many hardships you have come across, you can always move ahead with fresh perspectives. Maybe that's why Melancholia has the happiest ending ever, because of how it conveys a sense of hope. Von Trier has always surprised us with his stories on the big screen. Every film invites you to take a deep dive into a world of unthinkable possibilities. But his artistic choices are often criticized by associating them with pornography or declaring that he's just someone who makes movies for the sake of fulfilling his fantasies and calls them a piece of art. Now, just like I mentioned previously, Von Trier's life has not been a cakewalk. His mother revealed on her deathbed that the person whom he considered as his biological father is actually not his real father, and his birth was a result of a liaison that her mother wished to have so that Lars can inherit artistic qualities. On the top of that, his parents were true followers of naturism, and the young Lars would spend most of his vacations at nudist camps. He has gone through a lot of hardships, especially during his childhood, and is still recovering from depression and anxiety. He also suffers periodically from various fears and phobias, the biggest one being the phobia of flying. This is the reason why he likes to shoot all his films around Denmark and Sweden. For Von Trier, filmmaking is a gateway to happiness and pleasure. He likes to make movies about his personal experiences, along with sharing his ideologies about the intricacies of human relationships. His childhood experiences are probably the reason why he is not shy of depicting his fair share of realism by including explicit scenes that depict the journey of demolition of not just the human body, but also the mind and soul. He says that his film is like a pebble in a shoe, and all his stories are about a realist who comes into conflict with life. After taking a gap of 5 years, Von Trier has made an enormous comeback with The House That Jack Built. Though this movie turned out to be the most polarizing motion picture of 2018 and received more than 100 walkouts at the Cannes Film Festival, the film did receive a 10-minute-long standing ovation and tons of appreciation from those who genuinely understood the motive behind this film. When asked about the reason for working with Von Trier on The House That Jack Built, Matt Dillon said that the films he makes are very unique and they are not like any film that I have seen before. And honestly, I couldn't agree more. His next project is Etudes, a series of 10 black and white short films. And I don't think that Von Trier should ever get affected or influenced to change his style of filmmaking. He believes that all good art is created under dictatorial conditions. He feels that joining his venture of filmmaking is like going through a black forest. He's very confident of the path he has chosen. He knows the black forest inside out. All he is asking for is a vote of confidence as a friend from both the actors and the audience. And I think that he deserves to be trusted now and forever.